welcome back to today's episode of Back in the Day. And today we have the survivor of the horrific ordeal of the stabbing of Slender Man, and hope it. And this is the video, I think a couple months later. So, yeah.
Do you feel like you're a survivor?
Yeah, I shouldn't be alive. I really shouldn't after what happened.
For the first time, Peyton Leitner is talking about that day 5 years ago. Three 12-year-olds at a slumber party, and the next morning, a walk into the woods to play hide and seek.
Do you remember leaving the park to go to the woods?
They just wanted to go on a walk, and I didn't think much of it. It's just a walk. It's in Waukesha. Like, what bad stuff happens in Waukesha, Wisconsin?
Peyton was stabbed 19 times and left for dead by her own friends, who later blamed the fictional character, Slender Man.
Morgan handed me the knife, and then I started to count again. When I was 5 feet away, I said, now, go ballistic, go crazy. Stab, 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 stab.
The suspect lured the victim into the woods. All three of the girls are 12 years old.
Who's ever heard of two 12-year-old girls planning for 6 months to kill one of their best friends?
The whole time, Peyton was screaming through agony.
I didn't want to do this. I was afraid of what would happen if I didn't.
It's Friday night in Waukesha, Wisconsin, a Milwaukee suburb. Peyton is getting ready to celebrate her best friend Morgan Geyser's birthday at that slumber party.
Peyton was so, so excited.
The girls met in fourth grade, Peyton drawn to Morgan because she was a loner who needed a friend.
I made friends with her when I saw that she didn't have any friends at all.
Also at that sleepover, Anissa Wire, who was new to the school and who had grown close to Morgan.
They played up in Morgan's bedroom, ran up and down the stairs, giggling and laughing, and I mean, it was just a normal night.
But there was nothing normal about what happened the next morning when Morgan and Anissa suggest they all go to the park and then to the woods together.
Anissa told me to lie on the ground and like cover myself in like sticks and leaves and stuff, but it was really just a trick.
While playing hide and seek, then came Anissa's command, and Morgan attacks Peyton with a knife.
Morgan said, don't be afraid, I'm only a little kitty cat, and jumped on top of Bella and stabbed her repeatedly.
And do you remember when it started?
Kind of. I didn't feel anything because my body was in shock. So they told me to lay down, you'll lose blood slower. Like, we're gonna go get help.
And she tried to get up.
She tried to get up. She said that she couldn't see, she couldn't walk, and that she couldn't breathe.
And they told her they were going to go get her help. But Anissa flat out said, no, we weren't getting her help. We wanted her to die.
I got up and then just walked until I hit a patch of grass where I could lay down.
A bicyclist notices Peyton bloodied and lying in the grass. He calls 911. Officer Dan Klein is the first on the scene.
I asked her who did this, and she told me her friend, Morgan.
Peyton tells paramedics she's been stabbed.
They asked how long was the knife, and she said that the knife was about like this, and she was talking about the blade, not the handle.
Her mother rushes to the hospital just before Peyton is taken into surgery.
I said, you're gonna be okay, it's gonna be fine. But I could see that she was covered. Her arms and her legs and her abdomen, they were covered in stab wounds.
The surgeon treating Peyton told me if the stab wound to the chest had been the width of a human hair deeper, she would not have survived. While Peyton fights for her life, police are searching everywhere for the two girls.
It was about 2:53 in the afternoon. I had gotten a message that the sheriff's department had located the girls on the side of I-94. They were sitting on the side of the freeway.
By the time we found them, they had walked about 5 hours and made it to the north end of our city.
Morgan Geyser and Anissa Wire are brought back to the Waukesha police station for questioning.
Their demeanor was very calm. They seemed kind of meek.
Your parents know that you're here talking to me, okay?
and I'm glad they're so glad that you're safe.
I did notice she had a blood stain on the front of her shirt, and she was wearing two shirts.
Okay, what is your name?
Anissa Wyatt.
Morgan seemed like she was very calm, very relaxed. I mean, she's at a police department and she's covered in blood, and this is like a normal day for her.
You can hear Morgan ask what's happened to Peyton using her nickname, Bella.
Is she dead?
I don't know. She wants to take her to the hospital.
What? I was just wondering.
It didn't seem like it really concerned her too much if she was dead or alive.
The detectives read the girls their rights.
You have the right to remain silent.
Here in the state of Wisconsin, a child can be interrogated without the presence of their parent or guardian being in the room. At that time, I did not know that.
We find that people are more truthful when they don't have their parents present.
This is going to get me arrested, isn't it?
The interrogations last for hours.
Think these all kids a little bit more comfortable here?
I have a daughter that's almost the same age as her. Like, she could be my daughter, but then she started saying things that were really very eerie hearing them coming out of a 12-year-old's mouth.
So did you guys talk about doing this beforehand?
Anissa told me we had to.
Why?
Because she said that he'd kill our family.
Who's he?
A man. I didn't know him, but Anissa knew him.
And this is where the story takes another turn, to a fictional character on the internet.
There's this website called the Creepypasta Wiki. Okay. It's full of, like, horror stories that are meant to purposely scare you. And there's one of them called Slender Man.
Who's Slender Man?
He's this tall, faceless man who preys on children. At his own will, he can, exploit these tendrils from his back and, strangle his victim. From what the creepypasta Wiki said, he targets children most.
Anissa explained to me that to prove yourself worthy to Slender, you would have to kill somebody.
Morgan said, we have to kill Bella.
When we come back.
Did you feel bad? I just stabbed one of your best friends.
I thought about it, but then I decided that remorse will get me nowhere. It's easier to live without regrets.
Hi everyone, George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.
That's the end of today's episode, and catch us in our next episode of Back in a Day.